In March of 2018, I traveled to Chile, arriving on the first day of autumn. After spending a few days in Santiago, we proceeded further south and into the Andes Mountains. I had long wanted to see the land and meet the people who collect rose hips and who supply us with the precious oil that has been such a staple in my skincare practice and products. After all these years, I also wanted my own firsthand experience of seeing how this golden, silky oil of the rosehip gets from a thorny wild bush to a half-ounce-sized glass bottle. So a small group of us, armed with cell phones, cameras, an umbrella, and a drone, journeyed into the heart of the Chilean wilderness to see what we could see and learn what we could learn. The variety we use, Rosa Canina, grows wild in the Biobío and Maule regions of central Chile, and the collecting of rosehips begins just after the southern hemisphere's autumnal equinox and continues right through to the end of April. This is when the rosehip seeds are now brimming with the oil that supplies the diverse essential nutrients that play such a central role in therapeutic and holistic skincare. I was really surprised to watch the process of collecting rosehips. It was not at all what I had imagined. The men, called collectors, wear heavily padded protective gear and wear heavy work boots. They work quickly, reaching into a bush covered with thorns and expertly rake the rosehip off its branch and into the collector's sack without damaging the hip at all. The rosehip in the bag is unblemished and pristine. In fact, the rosehip continues to ripen and become more vibrant after harvest. I learned firsthand what a labor-intensive job it is to harvest rosehip. It requires awareness and endurance, along with heavy padding, to be able to do it safely and efficiently. Once geared up, the collectors use small but gnarly-looking hand rakes to remove the rose hips from the rose plants. They are raked right into a sack that hangs near their waist. Once it is filled, they empty the large sack, which can weigh between 25 and 40 kilos, into a waiting truck. These sacks are later delivered to the drying facility, where the rose hip will be washed, dried, and then processed in preparation for cold pressing. Towards the end of the day, we were driven to a picnic area shaded by an old oak tree that helped protect us from the wind and predicted rain. The men set up their day camp and started preparing food on an open grill that sat close to the ground. The meal our companions made us was exceptional. It consisted of a traditional asada of grilled meat, a vibrant salad, rice, delicious fresh berry juice, mate tea, and cake. Together we ate, relaxed, and enjoyed each other's company until the sun began its slow descent, and it was time for us to head home. We actually got lost going home, but that's a story for another time.